As a dog owner, you would probably like to know what kinds of foods are dangerous for your dogs. Not everything we as humans eat is safe for your furry friend. In this video, we will list the things your dog absolutely cannot eat under any circumstances. These foods will kill your dog and should be avoided at all costs. Watch this video to find out what they are. Macadamia nuts. Nuts are some of the healthiest foods for us humans, but your dog definitely should have a different diet from you, if you haven't realized it by now. Macadamia nuts are one of those things. Macadamia nuts are another type of food that could even kill your dog. They can be life-threatening for them. There have been many studies on this, but the cause for the macadamia nut poisoning is still unknown. Doses of only 2.4 grams could already affect the muscle strength of a dog. Large doses can cause symptoms to come up like tremors, fever, and vomiting. If your dog has ingested larger amounts of macadamia nuts, a vet should definitely be called. Your dog should be fine after only eating one or two of those nuts, but we wouldn't recommend that at all. It's much safer for dogs to stay away from macadamia nuts. Green potatoes. Although potatoes might seem harmless at first, especially because they are so healthy for us humans, they are very dangerous for dogs. The toxins the potato creates are super risky for your dog. Even a small amount can already cause a lot of stomach issues. The toxins in the potato are created to keep all the insects and pests away from the potato itself, but they are also very bad for your dog. These stomach issues that are similar to food poisoning, a little piece of potato is enough to cause these stomach issues. There are two different toxins that can cause these problems, one being solanine. Solanine causes heart problems, difficulty breathing, and gastrointestinal problems. While on the other hand, chaconine, the second toxin, causes irritation of the digestive tract, tremors, and kidney function disorders. The symptoms are usually mild, but it also depends on the number of potatoes your dog ate, the size of the dog, and whether the dog is ill. Common symptoms could be fever, headache, heart problems, vomiting, and even death. So keep your potatoes away from your dog. They are not safe. These toxins are mostly in the skin of the potato, but there is also a large amount of it in the potato itself. Caffeine. Another dangerous thing for dogs is caffeine. Many products used today contain caffeine, especially because some people really can't go without it. Some of them are more than others, such as chocolate, coffee, and cola, but don't ever give any of these products to your dogs. Dog owners should be extra careful with these products, since most people consume caffeine and dogs can't have it. Caffeine causes the heart rate to go up and can cause more than we humans think. Caffeine might not be as much of a problem to us, but that doesn't mean it can't cause harm to our dogs. The main problem with caffeine is that it causes heart problems if the dog gets too much caffeine. Symptoms of caffeine poisoning might include diarrhea, vomiting, elevated heart rate, and tremors. And if your dog has taken in too much caffeine, it could cause seizures and difficulty breathing. Keep your dog healthy and never give them anything containing caffeine. If your dog did take any caffeine, contact a vet as soon as possible. Salt. Salt is not as dangerous to us as it is to our dogs. Although, if a person takes in too much salt, it causes issues as well. Just like humans, dogs need salt too, also in smaller portions. Salt is good for the functionalities of the immune system and helps it get stronger, but giving them too much salt could cause some serious health problems. It is important to know how much sodium is the right amount a dog can take in. Usually, dogs already get enough salt from their daily diet and dog food, so there is no need to give them any extra, as this might cause dehydration and other issues if not looked out for properly. Just don't give your dog extra salt if there's no need for it. Dogs only need small amounts of salt. 1 5 grams of salt per pound of body weight is already enough to cause death. That is, if your dog accidentally eats something salty that they aren't supposed to eat, be careful with salty foods around dogs. Side effects of salt poisoning may include extreme dehydration, high blood pressure, tremors, and in some cases, even death. We all want our little furry friends to stay happy and healthy, so let's be careful with the salt. Onions. Onions might add a lot of taste to your food, but they are very dangerous for dogs. Onions contain a toxin known as n-propyl disulfide. It can cause the red blood cells to break down and leads to anemia in dogs. Unfortunately, every part of the onion is toxic to dogs. The flesh, the leaves, juice, and processed powders, also cooked, fried, and powdered, are just as bad for dogs. Problem is that onions are in almost everything, It only takes about 100 grams of onion per 20 kilograms for dogs to feel the toxic effects, which means that one onion is enough to cause serious health issues. This is a serious concern. Symptoms of onion toxicity might include vomiting, decreased appetite, fainting, and reddish urine. If you put onions in your dishes, please don't let your dogs eat any of it, as this might be life-threatening. If your dog shows any of these symptoms, bring them to a vet as soon as possible. The vet will try to induce vomiting, and they might, in the worst case, do a blood transfusion. This is because the dog can't make any of its own red blood cells temporarily. Grapes. Grapes might seem very harmless, mainly because you would think they are just pockets filled with water, but they are still very toxic to dogs. Although it is still unknown why exactly grapes are toxic to dogs, we do know what they cause. This also counts for raisins, as raisins are dried grapes. Grapes can be very fatal. They can cause kidney failure in dogs. The symptoms that might occur after ingestion are loss of appetite, vomiting, diarrhea, dehydration, and kidney failure. Contact a vet immediately if your dog did eat grapes or raisins. There is no correlation to different dog breeds and if they are affected by grapes. All dogs are indeed affected by grapes and raisins. Keep raisins and grapes away from dogs at all costs. Garlic. Garlic is good for us human beings and has various health benefits. Unfortunately, it doesn't have that same effect on dogs. It is, in fact, extremely dangerous for our furry friends. Garlic contains a toxin called thiosulfate. That same toxin is also in onions, causing anemia in dogs. Garlic toxicity also causes symptoms of gastrointestinal upset. This results in symptoms like vomiting, diarrhea, loss of appetite, and dehydration. About 15 to 30 grams of garlic per kilogram of body weight are needed to create harmful changes in the blood of a dog. So, there is a lot of garlic needed to cause them problems, but of course, there are different levels of sensitivity. Some dogs might be more sensitive to garlic than others. Don't ever feed your dog garlic. But if your dog does eat a bit of garlic, don't worry. Keep a close eye on them, and if you feel like your dog ate too much garlic, contact a vet as soon as possible. Yeast. The dangers with yeast might not be visible at first, but it is, as you might have guessed, extremely toxic to dogs. It is something that not a lot of people know, but yeast can cause major health problems for your dog. The two major things focused on with yeast are bloat and alcohol poisoning. Bloat happens when a dog eats a lump of dough. The yeast makes it expand because that's what happens under warm and moist circumstances. It causes the stomach of the dog to bloat and expand. This will result in a lot of discomfort and other health issues like reduced blood flow, rupture of the stomach lining, damage to the cardiovascular system, and increased pressure on the diaphragm. This might cause difficulty in breathing. Alcohol poisoning is caused by the yeast that produces ethanol during fermentation. The alcohol can get absorbed quickly in the bloodstream of the dog. Symptoms of alcohol poisoning in dogs include tremors, disorientation, and hypothermia. If your dog ate anything like raw dough, contact a vet as soon as possible, as this might be very dangerous for the dog. Keep an eye out for your dog while cooking, as they might still try to eat raw dough if it is sitting unattended. Chocolate. Last but not least, chocolate. Who doesn't love the sweet and delicious taste of chocolate? Dogs would definitely enjoy the taste as well, but they absolutely shouldn't consume it. Chocolate is extremely toxic for dogs. Depending on the weight of the dog, the type of the chocolate the dog ate, and the amount of the chocolate the dog ate, the side effects may include a faster heart rate and a stimulation of the nervous system. This could be lethal in some cases. If your dog ate chocolate, always contact a vet for further information and help. The dangers of chocolate are mostly in the caffeine and theobromine in the chocolate. These two substances can be very dangerous. The caffeine causes the heart rate to go up. Your dog might even get a seizure if it ate too much chocolate. The dangers of chocolate mostly lie in the cocoa powder. The darker the chocolate, the more dangerous it can be for your dog. Signs of chocolate poisoning usually include vomiting, diarrhea, seizures, and in the worst of cases, death. These signs usually appear after 6 to 12 hours of ingestion and may last up to 72 hours. So if you have a dog, don't give them chocolate. It is best to keep all of these products as far away as possible from your dog. They might not all immediately cause bad issues, but they will if ingested in large amounts. Many toxins in these products can make your dog extremely ill, and some might even cause death. Keep your furry friend away from your kitchen, or keep your potentially dangerous products behind closed doors. Which of these surprised you the most? Were you already aware of the dangers of these foods for your dog? Let us know in the comments. Maybe you have something you would like to add to this that you might want to share with us. Thanks for watching.